them for me.
I hug the Lord for giving me the best mom there could be. My mom has been helpful. She's kind and loving too. She teaches me about God's ways and things that I should do.
Today's message is on the subject of grace. To begin, I'd like to share a John Wesley quote with you. By nature, ye are wholly corrupted. By grace, ye shall be wholly renewed.
Today, we share with you some points of information as well as a couple Bible verses that turn those points into scripture. Our message today tackles some hard words. Actually, when we began working on this message, many of us couldn't even say any of these words. So, not only are the words hard to say, they are difficult to understand. We hope that our message, through music and words, will shine bright like a bonfire at night.
Giving your life to Jesus is making a Christian commitment to obeying and fulfilling the will of God. This sets you apart, and this makes you special.
Redemption is saving or being saved. Redemption is freedom from sin.
Sanctification is a state of growing in divine grace as a result of Christian commitment. The Bible tells us that sanctification is God's will for our lives and our soul. Sanctification is a process of becoming more like Christ by purifying our hearts and our minds. We can do this by coming to church, learning more about the Lord, acting like Jesus wants us to, and by talking to God through prayers.
Grace is one of our greatest gifts. Grace is one of the most important concepts taught in the Bible. Scripture is filled with verses about God's grace, and even though it is not something we deserve, God is kind to us and wants the best for our lives. Simply put, grace is the unmerited and undeserved love and favor of God.
Now let's turn to the Holy Scriptures for the Bible for some Bible facts. Hear these words, John 14:6. Jesus answered, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me."
Ephesians 1:7 says, "In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, in accordance with the riches of God's grace that are his very own, eager to do what is good."
"For it is by grace you have been saved, through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is from the gift of God." Ephesians 2:8.
And lastly, Titus 2:11-14 says, "For the grace of God has appeared that offers salvation to all people. It teaches us to say no to ungodliness and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in this present age, while we wait for the blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to redeem us from all wickedness and to purify for himself a people."
I've got We've got a few here already. Are you guys in the camping spirit? It's so good to see you all. I've got some really, really fun things planned for tonight so we can discover all the ins and outs of how God saves us.
I'm excited, but I wish my friend Grace was here. She promised me she was coming. Hey, look, there she is.
Hi, everyone. I'm Grace. I go to school with Eliza. Nice to meet you.
I'm so glad you made it. This is our group.
Hi, Grace. Would you like to help us with our mission tonight?
Sure. What type of mission is it?
Our first mission in tonight's journey is to find out where exactly we can find God's grace. It's kind of like a treasure hunt.
Well, I found Grace. That's no problem. There she is. There she is.
God's grace.
Yep, she did. That's right. I assume you guys brought flashlights? It's starting to get dark, so your flashlights can help you see. And anywhere your light shines, there you can find God's grace, too.
I'm sorry, but I'm a little confused. I've never heard of grace before. What is it?
Grace is a way that God reaches out to us, forgives us, and redeems us. And just like the way these flashlights shine everywhere we point, God's grace is all around us.
Yep, it's everywhere we look. So, tag, you're it.
Thank you.
Wow, that flashlight tag was great and all, but when are we going to have s'mores?
Oh, s'mores. I love s'mores. And I just happened to bring us a bag of organically produced, farm-to-table, no artificial ingredients, no artificial sweeteners, no artificial flavors, no GMOs, just pure, unadulterated marshmallows, and I'm anxious to try them.
Somehow, I don't even think Miss Olivia even knows what a marshmallow is.
I think you're right. All right, well, the fire looks about ready, so we can roast marshmallows in a bit while we talk about what we've learned so far. Grace, do you like s'mores?
Yes, I love s'mores. Me and my family always go on an annual camping trip every year. We always roast marshmallows for s'mores.
That sounds like so much fun.
Yeah, it really was fun. Well, at least it used to be.
What do you mean?
Well, my dad lost his job and he's been having a hard time trying to find a new one. My mom says we might have to move out of the state to go live with my grandparents for a while. We didn't even get to go on our camping trip this year.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Grace.
It's okay. I guess I'm trying to be brave. I don't want my little brother to see how scared I am of moving away.
We all get scared sometimes, Grace. But it's okay to be scared.
I mean, even I get scared. I mean, sometimes I worry about things like, what if I were to break a fingernail? Or, heaven forbid, what if my socks don't match my outfit? Or if a beautician goes out of town when I need a trim, I get scared.
Yes, yes, I think you guys are all bringing up great points. Grace, we all get scared of what the future holds. It's hard to know what lies ahead, but I have really great news. We have a savior who's making a way for us, a path of grace for our entire lives from the moment we were born. That means we don't have to be scared just as long as we trust him.
But how can grace already be in the future? That doesn't make any sense.
Well, God promises to go before us every step of the way, our whole entire life. So even when it gets scary, you can know that God is prepared for that. He is with you and he will give you courage.
You know, I never heard of grace until tonight, but it sounds really cool. Maybe you guys could teach me more about it.
Yeah, we would love to, Grace.
And at least you got to come to a mini camp sleepover.
Already there. Now, all I have to do is crop that church out from behind me so people will think I'm really in the wilderness.
Oh, Miss Olivia, you could be hugging a bear right now, and I don't think anyone would believe that you were in the wilderness.
Girls, I have this wonderful idea. Let's have a camping clothing fashion show.
That sounds like a great idea for you, but luckily for the rest of us, I brought a volleyball. I'm going over there, far away from any fashion show.
All right, y'all, as great as both of those ideas sound, I have something a little different in mind. We have a new friend here who wants to learn more about God's grace, and as much as volleyball games and fashion shows sound like a lot of fun, it's not as important as God's grace, right?
Oh, I don't know. It's important that we always look good, but oh well, I mean.
You're right.
I have a lot of questions about God's grace. I guess it sounds really cool, but I don't understand how to get it. Like, why would God give me grace?
Do you have a Bible, Grace?
No, I don't.
We have one for you. Can I get a flashlight over here, please? Okay, see right here in John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son. Whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
I still don't get it.
Oh, dear Grace. God's grace is always with us. It's always been here, even before we knew him. He is our Lord, our Savior, and our friend.
Yeah, that's right. The Bible says that the wages of sin is death, but this passage lets us know that God covers grace, that grace covers the price of everything we've ever done. He loves us so much that he wanted to make sure we could live with him forever.
That's what it means to be saved, to love him as your Savior and trust him to guide you.
Grace, would you like to do that this evening?
Sure, how do I do it?
All you have to do is ask. Come on, girls, let's get together. Come. And now we're going to bow our heads and we're going to say a prayer with grace for grace.
Dear Lord, thank you for bringing me to this camp out. I am excited to get to know you better and have the same grace all my friends here have. I ask that you forgive me for all the wrong things I've done in my life and save me so I can have eternal life too. Help me to love you each day. Thank you for grace. Amen.
Amen. Amen. That was absolutely beautiful, Grace. I'm so proud of you for taking that huge step. How do you feel?
I don't know. It feels weird. It feels like that I'm excited for the future, even though I don't know it's coming. It's such a change. Mm-hmm.
We'll be right back.
Well, I think it's time that you all put up this mess of a tent.
How does putting up a tent have anything to do with God's grace?
You'll figure it out. Get to work.
A tent.
Yes, I can.
It goes like this, not that.
Not this way. No, that way.
Just give me the hammer. There you go. That's how you do it.
No, wrong. That's not how you do it. That's wrong.
You're doing this completely wrong. I'm telling the art teacher that you don't know how to do this.
Yes, I do. You're
so
a liar.
Wrong.
Liar.
We got gifts for you?
No.
Oh my gosh.
Go that way.
That has to be right. Is that right?
Yes.
It has to be. See, what? Didn't agree with me. Yep.
All right.
Whoa, that was hard work.
I still don't understand how putting up a tent has anything to do with God's grace.
Well, we just talked about how we're all messes. I mean, look at our hair, our clothes. But God's grace will save us anyway. I mean, just like that tent. It was old, it was smelly, it was wet. And look what you all did. Voila, we have us a tent. It's a warm, safe place to sleep in.
We sure did.
I've been wondering, what comes next? Now that I've accepted Jesus into my heart, I know he saved me, but how do I become something that he can use?
I knew you'd figure it out. Have you ever heard of the word sanctification?
Did you say snaptification? I think I'll go get our marshmallows for s'mores.
No, Miss Olivia. Sanctification. I've heard of it, but I still don't really know what it means.
That's okay, it's a big word. It means that his grace not only saves us, but it completes us. Just like how you made that not so great looking tent work, he can take our unworthiness and turn it into something beautiful.
I think I get it. That's what it means to be redeemed, right?
Exactly.
I want to be sanctified. But I'm worried that when I move, that I'll forget it and it will be harder to...
Yeah.
It will be harder. But thankfully, God just doesn't really just help us and then leave the scene. He's here to stay, and he will be with you for all the way.
Yeah, that's right, Grace. Grace is all you'll ever need to be made to feel new.
And somehow I knew what I wanted and I needed, what was His grace could do. Grace is a broken pieces, it sees me at my weakest, forgives and makes me clean, tells me I'm redeemed. Grace is all I really ever need for all of me.
This has been so much fun, but I'm really getting tired. I do need my beauty rest.
I'm tired too, but I'm really sad for it to end.
Don't worry. The best decision that you've made tonight is that it's never ending. And now you can go out and tell all your friends and family about tonight's journey of grace.
Yeah, I can't wait to tell my family. It will be such good news after all we've been through.
Yeah, that's a really great attitude to have, Grace. In fact, we should all have that attitude. Tomorrow's a new day, and that means there's new opportunities to be ambassadors of God's grace. And that's the thing about grace. It goes on and on and on, and so there's more than enough for everyone.
Do you all even know what an ambassador is?
I do. An ambassador is someone that carries a message, and why wouldn't we? I mean, it's the best news ever.
I feel like my whole life has changed tonight. Just imagine how many kids at school need this.
Wow, even kids like us can make a big impact.
Yep. Thank you so much for inviting me here. I want to exchange phone numbers with you all. That way, when I do move, that I can still keep in contact with you, so it won't be so hard.
I have this wonderful idea. I will start a group chat, and of course I'll be the leader, and we'll have t-shirts alike, and we'll have a really cool name. It will be wonderful.
Yes, that does sound wonderful. I'm so proud of you guys tonight. Not only have you all learned something, but you helped a friend accept God into her life, and that's kind of the whole reason we're here.
Yep, because God's grace goes on and on and on.
And on and on and on.
Mm-hmm.
And on.
Yes. Oh, yes, yes, we get it. That's the spirit, everyone.